Hello, everyone. Well, that was kind of lame. Hello, my faithful followers of all things motorcycles, squids, baby yams, and even those who found my channel through a rabbit hole. I hope you find the video on how to fix your washing machine eventually. It was probably the basket hub assembly anyways. Hello, I'm Yami Noob. Stick around long enough and you'll either start riding a motorcycle or win one. Today we dive into the age-old question of whether we need more automatic motorcycles. Now, it sounds a little bit controversial, but let me explain. In the early days of cars and bikes, everything was mostly manual. It was uncommon to have someone who couldn't drive a stick shift, especially for males. But now, an entire generation is leaning towards alternative transmissions that don't require manual shifting. CVT, Manumatic, F1-inspired paddle shifting, and other forms of clutchless transmission are becoming quite popular, which is leading everyone to expect the same from motorcycles. Are manual transmissions on bikes a barrier to entry for people? Will we start to see automatic motorcycles more and more? Well, I'm not sure how I feel about all that, but in today's video, we will attempt to shine some light on the subject. Now, before we begin on today's episode, you gotta know that I'm giving away 3 motorcycles. Now, these motorcycles I'm giving away, they're not automatic, but they are in fact manual, and they are the Honda CB650R, Kawasaki's Ninja 400, and Suzuki's DRZ400. Click the links below, find out how you can get entered to win completely for free. If you go on our merch page as well, every dollar you spend gets you an entry to win. Or if you go on our website, yaminoob.co, you can sign yourself up for a tier 2 package, $20 a month, get yourself some access to our Discord server, get 200 entries to win our bikes, and much more. Click the links below and check it out.
Now let's discuss automatic motorcycle. The first thing we gotta think about is who rides an automatic motorcycle? Before we start flaming people for being too lazy to learn or mentally incompetent to learn how to ride a manual transmission bike, let's look at some of the people who actually need an automatic. First, we have those who aren't physically capable. Think about issues with the left leg or the left hand. Maybe an accident has left a former rider looking for an easier alternative to a manual transmission. Nerve damage is a hell of a thing. Another group of people are those vacationing but not entirely interested in becoming a motorcyclist. I hate to say it, but in some countries, you can rent a motorcycle for a day, which I guess would lead to tourists and inexperienced riders trying to get one. I don't make this stuff up. Apparently, when you go on your dream vacation, the lure of finally jumping on a motorcycle seems like a great idea in a foreign country. Some people rent the mopeds or scooters but have never been on two wheels. This becomes scary for someone that's never been on a bike to start in a foreign country. For the sake of a need, we'll say that the tourist needs an automatic and not a manual, which is why a lot of scooters and mopeds come with that slush box transmission. Another rider who might need an automatic is someone who works while riding the motorcycle. Sometimes the police in pursuit could forgo the clutching and shifting, while other riders such as couriers need to focus more on their city traffic skills as opposed to their shifting skills. That's why if you go in densely populated cities like London or Paris, you'll see plenty of motorcyclists riding mopeds and scooters, all while never touching a clutch lever. I'm not saying that because you ride as a cop or a courier that you need an automatic. I'm saying that some people in certain occupations have physical limitations that might need a different transmission, or they just don't really want to be shifting gears all day long. Now, the second thing is, why do we need them? If there's no demand, then why do we supply it? This is a simple rule in economics. If the demand exists, supply it and turn a profit. But in the cases of Apple, there was never a demand for the iPod. People just bought it because they knew they needed it. Apple created the demand for its own product and then sold it. Much the same with automatic bikes. If they produce more, such as an automatic CBR600 or other 600cc bike, would someone buy it? Someone not interested in motorcycling, would they finally pull the trigger and buy it because it's automatic? If the current lineup of automatic bikes is boring, well, you're right. You won't find any high-end leader bikes that are auto, nor a turbo busa. People want these things so badly, we'll pay the price to learn. However, a weird thing to think about is top-end leader bikes nowadays, with their clutchless quick shifting both up and down, means that you really just need to learn how to use the clutch from a standstill, and then from there, you don't really need to learn how to use the clutch. So are these bikes automatics? Interesting. If the MotoGP starts using automatic leader bikes, get ready because it's about to trickle down to every last Ninja 250 on the planet. Is there a need for large quantity of automatics right now? Papa says no. But that MotoGP technology has been trickling down to the leader bike class. Again, quick shifting up and down. That's kind of an automatic if you think about it. The barrier. If you're interested in motorcycling, does a transmission scare you? In total honesty, I think every rider at one point or another became scared or overwhelmed with how many things you had to do just to move forward at 10 miles per hour. You gotta release the clutch slowly, add throttle, keep your balance, maybe drag the rear brake, balance it a little bit more as your speed increases, pull in the clutch, then release the throttle, upshift with your left foot, repeat until you reach your desired speed. It's a lot to think about. For all the noobs in the MSF and for those just starting, you've probably stalled a few times, missed some shifts, or even forgot to release your throttle while shifting. Did you pop a nice little dank nooner? The idea of manual shifting on top of everything else, counterbalance, countersteering, throttle control, leaning, looking for the apex, the list is endless. It might seem daunting at some. With only 40 cars manufactured brand new with a manual transmission, the reality is that people want less to do for driving, but to be able to do more during driving. Who needs manuals when you have self-driving cars and lane keep assist and all kinds of stuff? The industry is teeter-tottering on the next direction to go. Exotic cars like Ferraris, Lamborghinis, and even the Nissan GTR use manual transmissions that are electronically shifted. They actually shift faster than every human being ever could, and do not miss shifts. It's almost too good to pass up on current technology. Row your own gears down the quarter mile and you could lose due to a missed shift. Automatics and electronically controlled transmissions will never have that problem. So if you've ever missed a shift on your bike, you know it kind of buzzes or grinds and it always sounds a little expensive. With the majority of the population driving automatics, when they see that flyer for the MSF course, they suddenly want the same automatic feel on a bike. I think if someone is capable, they shouldn't be allowed to skip out on the manual. They should learn on one. The refusal or even ignorance. In today's world, everyone is offended by everything. Look, someone just got offended by me saying that. It's no surprise in the current state of affairs, there's a huge debate on both the quantity of genders and the quantity of rounds a rifle magazine can hold. It's no surprise that people wouldn't even consider manual bikes as a barrier, but would be offended that the ideal bike isn't offered the option of an automatic. Suzuki probably won't release a lineup of automatic-only Gixxers. Sorry. If you want a squid, you gotta learn how to ride at a minimum. Gear is always recommended, but optional if you're gonna be squidding. I get the tourist kind of feel when it comes to people that demand certain bikes and automatic. Have you ever heard tourists talk about their scuba diving vacations? Scuba diving is actually really similar to riding a bike. You don't just jump in blindly, get involved, and jump in metaphorically, yes, but physically jump in and you'll either low side a bike or in no time die from the bends if you don't take at least a 4-hour class on diving. Seriously, scuba diving is actually really dangerous. Did you know that? Our hobby doesn't need riders who are ignorant and refuse to adapt in total honesty. If you're gonna start something new, approach it with an open mind. Yes, there are a limited number of automatic bikes out there. Yes, you can buy one. Honda makes a DCT for the Africa Twin, for example. But the MSF course is 99.9% likely to only have manual transmission bikes because 99% of bikes sold have manual transmissions. Don't be ignorant when you approach motorcycling without knowing about it. Every rider is in the same position that you are now, contemplating an easier bike to ride, but they persevered and made through it. Adapting. The industry is already manual, at least 99% of it. Adapting to the will or wants of such a small population, it might become too expensive. How many MSF courses will the automatic bike sit in the garage for? How do you license a rider that took the test on an automatic bike? Can they legally ride a manual bike? The problem of adaptation becomes a financial and liability concern. This is the same for the trucking industry. New drivers can test out on automatic semi-trucks, but then hold a restricted CDL, allowing them to only operate an automatic truck. As a fleet manager, how do you manage these drivers? Do you consider hiring them? The same principle applies to motorcycle riders. With some sort of restricted endorsements, riders can't be borrowing their friend's manual bike. What happens if they crash and they hurt someone? They weren't properly licensed for it. I'll admit it's strange that car drivers don't have a restriction to transmission type, but everyone else would, nor does. For the motorcycle industry to adapt, it would be financially burdensome and difficult. For the liability portion, the MSF would need to offer automatic bikes, but then transfer the skills test for an automatic-only restriction on an endorsement. Insurance companies would probably charge a premium on policies for automatic-only riders. And what about the rider? What happens if they try to learn to ride a manual? Do they have to retest? It's all a bit messy. Manual solutions to an automatic world. Do we need more automatics is the question. I think it's up to the rider to determine whether they need an automatic or a manual. I will say this, every capable rider should test out for their endorsement, whether through an MSF course or the DMV exam, on a manual transmission bike. If the rider utilizes their freedom, they can purchase an automatic motorcycle or convert it or whatever. There are companies such as the Shift FX by Performance Development Corporation that has a retrofit shift kit for nearly every motorcycle. The kit will convert a bike from manual to semi-automatic or fully automatic, transmission, not guns, guys, and allow the rider to choose on the fly between the three. It retains the manual capability but adds the options of automatic modes. Until there is a dire need for automatics, such as a new law going against manufacturers, which I don't think will ever happen, I think the manual transmission is here to stay. It allows for more control over the motorcycle and you can finesse a little bit better, and it's just the classic way to ride a bike. If you know how to ride a manual transmission motorcycle, you can apply those skills to any motorcycle. Looking back at the MSF course, there were people that had never shifted a motorcycle, let alone sat on one, who were able to shift it safely in a parking lot on the second day. Don't be afraid. Dive right in and don't give a shift. Now, what do you guys think? Automatic bikes, a plague, a necessary evil, or the inevitable march of progress? I really do think that leader bikes with quick shifters both up and down are basically automatic bikes, to be honest. Let me know in the comments below. I do love hearing from you guys. And of course, don't forget to check out our beginner bike giveaway series. All the bikes we're giving away are manual. Unfortunately, there are no automatic bikes on our giveaway. As a reminder, I've got a manual Honda CB650R, a manual Suzuki DRZ400, and a manual Ninja 400, all waiting to be given away for free. Click the link below, get pre-registered so you can receive your special discount code when we launch, and you can get notified as soon as we're live. Thanks again for watching. Tune in next time. See you later. Fact: if you're an avid comic book fan, there's no doubt you'll be impressed by the collection that Bob Bratall of Mission Viejo, California has managed to put together. In 2015, he nabbed the world record for the largest comic book collection with 101,822 unique items. Goodbye.